Randy's Random Rants.
Going to rent the car so they can go out of town in, but don't leave. Make sure she get the car first.
Carrie claims he circled the airport before spotting the woman in her rental.
Hurry up and get out! Why y'all take so long?
But as Carrie's passengers exited his vehicle and stepped into the rental car, he became suspicious.
I feel something is wrong because it was an elderly man in the passenger side of the vehicle.
Police ask Carrie if he can ID his four passengers. Carrie doesn't know the names of all the young men, but he can confirm the identity of his friend's aunt.
One of them I identified right then. I told him it was Miss Mary.
Carrie Yancey told the sheriff's office that he had driven Shonda Merritt to the airport.
Carrie also tells police there's someone who was not in the vehicle, but who can identify his other passengers. A young man named Montrell Davis.
Montrell is the nephew of Shonda Merritt, and he reached out to his friend Yancey and asked for him to take his aunt to the airport.
Police reach out to Montrell Davis, who identifies two of the three male passengers in Mr. Sukup's rental car. Shonda Merritt's son, Marquavius Avery, and Marquavius's friend, Corey Harrington.
Slowly but surely, the Jacksonville Sheriff's Office starts putting together the pieces and start picking up people to interview.
While they still have an unidentified fourth suspect on the loose, detectives press forward with the two males they have in custody. First on the list is Corey Harrington. Corey is initially uncooperative, but eventually he starts talking after a little prodding from a loved one.
I love you, Corey, but you talk to him. It just hurts me that you get tied up with people like that and get you to this point.
His grandmother said, you know, you've got to come clean. And so he eventually is extremely cooperative.
Corey tells police that once Shonda was dropped off at the airport, she stalked Charles Sukup as he made his way to his rental car.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
I work for the rental car company,
yeah.
And I just want to take you up there so you don't get lost.
Then smooth-talked her way into the driver's seat.
This is what we do as procedure.
Once behind the wheel of Mr. Sukup's vehicle, Shonda picked up Corey and the two other young men.
Marquavius and Corey and another gentleman got out of Mr. Yancey's vehicle and got into the victim's vehicle.
Although Corey cannot identify the fourth passenger, he was aware of the intentions of the group.
He said that they was following on their plan.
So you guys killed
Corey
this old man for nothing?
Exited the rental lot.
Yeah, if I'm the judge, listen. Life, all of y'all. Simple.
Corey couldn't bear to watch what happened next.
Listen, you need to do none of your business.
I didn't
want to
see him. Anything,
I don't care what the story is. Life, all of you.
Corey says the popping sound he heard was in fact gunfire. One member of the group had shot Mr. Sukup at point blank range, at which point the group fled the scene in the rental vehicle, leaving Sukup's dead body behind.
We interviewed him for several hours, and he ended up telling us where Mr. Sukup's body was. And he actually took us out to where it was.
Corey's cooperation buys him little leniency. Police place him under arrest and charge him with murder.
He knew he was caught at that point, and he believed he'd be going to jail for the rest of his life.
As Corey Harrington is carted off to county jail, investigators survey the area where Charles Sukup's body was discovered. They soon stumble upon a set of tire tracks. A casting is made, and the tread is a match to that of the tires of Mr. Sukup's rental car.
That is a damn
Between
shame.
Between the eyewitness accounts and the physical evidence, investigators are confident they can not only link Charles Sukup's murder to the shooting of Carl Davis, they can finger Shonda Merritt as the mastermind behind both crimes.
Ms. Merritt was very angry about the breakup and wanted Mr. Davis dead. And to do that, she's in need of a car. And then, of course, they take the car and Mr. Sukup.
But just as the case file is coming together, police are thrown yet another curveball. In addition to Carl's love-scorned ex-girlfriend, Shonda Merritt, They've arrested two other suspects, Shonda's son, Marquavius Avery, and Marquavius's friend, Corey Harrington.
To coordinate the murder of an individual with your son in the car, that definitely blew my mind.
On the line was his old flame, Shonda Merritt.
Hello?
Shonda was going out of town and wanted Carl to hold some money for her.
Yeah, all right.
She needed him to pay her rent, make sure that her kids had a place to stay.
Yeah, let's do it. Where?
Carl agrees to meet her near a local gas station.
That nigga must have been busting that pussy open, son. For you to plot all of this over a motherfucker that ain't thinking about you. He's laying in his bed, living his life.
Somebody from the backseat of the car popped up and shot at him.
Yo, you go take your kids, your friends, family, all of that shit. And go try and kill somebody because they don't want to beat on your fucking twat no more.
Because Carl Davis's first words,
that nigga was fucking destroying that pussy. That's what I get from this whole story right here. That's what this whole story means right here. When you meet a bitch, you can't be giving her all that dick. You gotta give her at least half of the dick. Know what I'm saying? You can't just shove it all in.
Investigators are baffled. If Raymond Austin,
they're killers.
15-year-old Raymond formed an intense bond with Shonda shortly after he began dating her daughter Deidre.
Shonda Merritt's relationship with Raymond Austin was, in one word, bizarre.
Questionable.
Ray Austin's relationship may have been inappropriate, kind of attached at the hip.
Regardless of the nature of the relationship, one thing was clear. Rather than Raymond's Christian values rubbing off on Shonda, Shonda Merritt sucked Raymond into her life of crime.
Shonda Merritt was a bad influence on Raymond Austin.
It seemed like Ray Austin would stop at nothing if Shonda. She could say jump, and he would say how high.
Circling back to both crime scenes.
Well, tell her to write a letter to him right now and tell his ass to jump. That's what I suggest. Go visit her and go tell her to write this nigga a letter and tell him to fucking jump real high.
After the shooting, Raymond Austin is arrested.
Raymond Austin was apprehended by the U.S. Marshals Fugitive Task Force and transported to the homicide office for interview.
At first, Raymond is reluctant to speak, but when detectives explain how serious the
you guys actually got to take pictures, when you take pictures, you guys actually
kind of defiant. It wasn't
you guys got to actually look mean and mad and like you want to kill somebody.
He had to admit his
involvement. Let's not go and play a good
Raymond
part in your fucking future if you choose to do stupid shit like this.
Boy.
He actually set the interview room up like a inside of the vehicle, and he actually demonstrated on me how he choked Mr. Suga.
He demonstrated? What's going on?
She was looking, so I was like, this time. Like, trying to make, it seemed like I was doing it, trying to kill her.
Yeah, okay.
He claimed that when Shonda realized
and
he
we're supposed to all believe that shit. The man is
him,
dead, bro.
At that point,
what are you scared? You scared of this lady? You scared of a fucking bitch?
In a very rural area.
Listen, you ain't handling your business. Where's the gun? Get the gun now.
And you got the gun. You got the gun and you scared of this bitch. I'd have shot her ass like, yeah, okay, here, turn around. Pow! Nigga, word.
Pow! Off on Shonda Merritt and essentially made himself out to be a pawn that he was just acting in her direction.
That's what they all fucking do.
Chant was already in the control room. If she asked them to do anything, they would have done it with no regard, with no remorse, just to please her.
Raymond Austin's confession gives investigators the ammunition they need to charge him with first-degree murder, attempted murder, kidnapping, and armed robbery.
Are you guys happy?
Raymond Austin was 17 years old at the time of the offense, but because of the charges were so serious, he was in adult court.
Similar charges are filed against Shonda Merritt.
Good
and
shit.
And Shonda, the crime's alleged mastermind that prosecutors are truly gunning for.
She just did whatever she wanted to do. If she wanted to do it, she did it. and it didn't matter if it was against the law or not.
But as Shonda's trial approaches, prosecutors can't help but wonder, will the case even make it to court?
Shonda Merritt does have a bona fide medical condition. We were having bouts of whether she was actually going to be well enough to actually have the
trial. Oh, she did the OJ.